If you've been watching my channel for any length of time, you probably already know I load a lot of shotgun shells using Lyman and other published data. Over the years, I've also developed a large number of custom loads, many of which require filler wads or overshot cards to get the correct shot column and a good crimp. Although these aren't the most expensive components on the market, they still add up, particularly if you need several per shell. To make matters worse, they're often difficult to find, particularly if your local gun store stops stocking the brands you're accustomed to. With this in mind, I've designed and manufactured my own custom punch for producing 12-gauge filler wads. The model you see here represents my prototype, which I've been using and testing for quite a while now. Today I'm going to introduce you to the design and show you how it works. The die is made from stainless steel so that it won't rust or corrode, while the punch is hardened tool steel that's rigid enough to remain perfectly straight and maintain an edge. I specifically designed this punch to fit in a standard reloading press to help keep the cost low and better utilize the equipment I've already got. To install it, we'll begin by inserting the punch and raising it up to the top. Next, we'll thread the die in place. This helps ensure things are aligned properly. Operation is likewise extremely simple. You'll see there's a slot cut in the side to allow a multitude of different materials to be fed into the die. So far, I've tested it with cardboard and vegetable fiber. In the future, I'll likely try cork as well. With the material in place, it's a simple matter of operating the press handle and punching filler wads. Each one comes out the exact internal diameter of a standard 12-gauge shotshell wad. If I need to produce a lot and don't want to make a mess, I just place a margarine container with a hole in the bottom onto the nozzle at the top of the die and punch as many as I need. With a good supply of these on hand, it's no trouble at all to customize my shot columns by placing them above or below my shot or slugs. Likewise, if I've got a difficult load to crimp well like low volume birdshot or round ball slugs, adding one to the top as an overshot card makes things a snap. I'm really happy with how the punch turned out and already working on designs for a 20 gauge model. If things go well, I may try some others too, like a 410, 16, or even 28 gauge.